fire headed down the slope directly behind the house, quickly burning it to the ground.
The fire got ahead of us and outstripped our resources.
The rugged hillside that's the backdrop to these homes is charred.
All you can see is the foundation. There's some really scorched trees here. Basically, nothing's left.
More than 1,900 personnel working in this area aren't going to be calling it quits anytime soon.
This is our frontline engine. It's called an urban interface engine. It's designed for structure and wildland. And we're in an urban interface, so that's what it's designed for.
The fire would come through and it would literally leave islands in the middle of a big burn area. Mm. And ironically, there was a lot of these islands that actually had homes in them. Several days later, the islands would blow up, and it was just very, very, very difficult to try to protect structure, in that type of situation. And it's funny, too, you get out on a fire line, you have to be about half a weatherman all the time. You'll notice your body kind of noticing weather changes constantly. In fact, one of our biggest fears is you're looking at a fire and you feel cool air on the back of your neck. You get that big plume domination fire, it's just sucking all that air up in there. Jake snores like crazy, so nobody sleeps. It's just well with Carrie's experience in wildland situations, we rely on pretty heavily in this department because of his experience. Mm-hmm. We're constantly picking his brain. Here in Ryan Park, we've done a lot of structure protection already in our trainings and trying to protect the homes that we do have up here and mitigation and what have you. So to go down there and actually put it into play in a live fire situation was very, very comfortable because of that training. And that's one thing I will say about our chief up here. He is huge on training.
I've been on the fire department for 2 years since I was 18, and I got a phone call. I packed my bags, drove up here, and we got the truck ready and left. And it was a matter of just like 3 hours. We pretty much woke up. Carrie would go to briefing. We would get the truck ready for like in the morning. He would come up, he'd give us a briefing. He would tell us the weather, what we were doing that day, and then we'd go there and do it. We were pulling like 15 and a half, 16 hour days, but it's totally worth it. It's fun. I don't know if there really was a scary moment. I mean, we were on structure protection, so we didn't really get right up to the main part of the fire. Okay. Well, we had spent a few days on the house, and below it there was a fire, and it crowned up into the trees and then ran up the hill, and we did lose that house, but I guess that was kind of a bummer than more than anything. Carrie's knowledge on the fire. I didn't. We went on the fire. I know the basic training, but he told me more about weather and everything that I would have never guessed without more training. And he helped me a lot. It was great, the knowledge and stuff that I learned.